السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Today we'll take you back to الحلمية to live with me at that time of the 50s to see different professions came out as a pioneering or innovative ways of people who did not want actually to beg others for their life. One of them was actually the street photographer. The street photographer used to go to the parks with his camera. His camera was big and he's standing on three legs. And there is a lens in front and a big piece of clothes he has to cover himself while he has taken the photograph of the children and the family, then take the film and develop it and give it to the children and to the family at that time. The second profession, which was actually when the sewer main pipe are blocked on the street, people used to call the government offices to bring some people to clean it. What happened at that time? Amongst those men who used to come to our area, a man who has to take off all his clothes and to jump in and to find the blockage, and he might be staying for 1 or 2 or 3 minutes, and the children were looking at him. Everybody was shocked, because when he comes out, you can see what is on his hair and his back and his hand. And this poor man, I don't know, he had any health problem, his salary, his insurance. It's very inhumane profession. The third one was actually the second-hand salesman used to come and make noises, calling upon people in the balcony, people behind the windows, people behind curtain to send the second-hand items at home, whether it is a chair, broken chair, or it's a jacket, or it's a trouser, or it is anything in the house. And we call him the second-hand man, or actually Rababikia. Rababikia was the name of the thing. There was another second-hand market where whenever you go there to find everything that you dream to find. Another profession, which is knife sharpener. This man, who is actually called the knife sharpener, used to carry on his shoulder a big device made about of a wooden wheel, actually, and standing on 3 or 4 legs and with a device at the bottom. And whenever they gave him the knives, the big knives and the small knives, he used to put it on a stone there and press his foot to try to get the wheel to sharpen the knife, etc. Salesman, as I mentioned, everything, vegetable, fruits, bread, milk, anything that you can imagine, those salesmen come to the street to try to sell it to you. Worn clothes mending. The worn clothes mending, it was another very skillful profession. How people in the good old days, when they are poor and have poor income, when their trousers become old and ruined, and especially at the knee side or the back here, or the jacket with the elbows, and all this. They used to go to this one man who can actually mend it for them. He used to go to put a patch from inside and stitch it with a very, very fine thread to be the same color of the material of the trouser or the jacket and others. It was very skillful men at the time. A health barber. Health barber, this was actually the stage before sending doctors and medical team to the countryside. Health barber, he used to be the man, actually have a small shop, either in the backyard of Cairo or in the countryside, where he can do the circumcision for boys and girls at that time, and can actually, if there's an abscess, can open it up, and sometimes used to make this kind of some recipes, actually to heal something. Most of the health barber did disastrous problems affecting the people they were trying to treat. Darvish at that time were crooks, mostly crooks, used to sit in a flat or in a house, and inside the dark room they are sitting it. In it, you find that there's a lot of smokes, different colors of smokes, and you find him wearing different kind of clothes, which are covered by a lot of patches, and with a lot of tasbih, big tasbih around the neck, and with a hat on his head. And whenever anyone come to his room, the private room or the consulting room or the examination room, actually find all these smoke, so you can sometimes you cannot even see what you call him, Darwish or Mushawiz. But in the reception room, he used to have one or two of his assistant sitting with the people. A woman is wanted to make something wrong for her husband, or her husband is not in love with her, and she wants, yani, all this kind of problems, social problems at home, they come. And when they sit down in the reception room, actually one of his assistants used to sit down with them to know her name, to know or his name, and know the problems, and they disappear, and they go and tell the sheikh or the dervish at the time the name of the woman, what's she complaining, or the name of the woman is complaining from. And once she come to the room, which is full of smoke, you can imagine, like the magician, you know what? He will tell her, oh, Umm so and so, come in. How is your husband? Why is that? And she will become impressed of that he knew her story before even she come to the room. And the peep show is, as another man used to carry on his shoulder, a big piece of device, which is have a lot of windows or to let the children to sit on a desk that he is carrying as well with some of his assistants. And from behind, he used to start to play some music, as well as to have this kind of machine to get the images from this square to this square to this square to square, about the old traditional historical stories that the children are very happy to see them. Then there's a peep show. The puppeteer was a clown, which is called a funny clown. He used to come also, though before the circus was developed at that time, he used to come to the streets in different dresses, and sometimes they play with fire, and they get somebody to play with the fire to them, and all the children will be surrounding them, and the people at the end of the day, they throw some pennies to those people who come to the funny clowns. A magician or a snake charmer. The magician or the snake charmer, this one individual used to have few snakes with him, and to put it around his neck and to play with the snakes, and actually let scare the children as well. Fire player, who mentioned it, monkey man. The monkey man used to have a small monkey with himself, with a drum, and he's actually tying the monkey and have got the rope in his hand, and ask the monkey to jump and dance and make the way behave like the man who is not married, how he sleeps in the bed. The people actually who are hungry, how they don't have food at home, and make a lot of these funny images of the people actually, and people used to laugh and actually at these acts made by the monkey man. So when we look at all this, some of them might be still in functioning, like actually the monkey man, I saw it in Pakistan 2 years ago. It was a monkey and a goat actually, but the rest I have not seen it somewhere else. This will give us a signal that actually people, the poor people in this city or in this town, did not want to stretch their hands for begging, but they wanted to innovate a profession to keep them going and make actually a good service to the people. Thank you very much, and if you like the video, please share it with your colleague.